Hello and welcome to Plastotech in English. Guys, this is our English channel and in this particular video I am going to tell you about how we set the production counter. Production counter is an important setting in injection molding machine. So in this particular video I am going to show you how we set the production counter in injection molding machine. What is production counter and how we analyze it? These things you will get. So please subscribe and press the bell icon so that I can start the video. So guys, here you can see that each and every particular setting has been named and mentioned according to its uses. So before starting, just I am showing you how I am going to move in this particular HMI. This is production set page as it has been written there. You can clearly see that there are certain options like required production, number of cavities, remaining cycle counter, total cycle counter, and all those things you will get here. So starting from the beginning, the first one is required production. That means here you are going to set how much production is required for you. Right now I have set it here 1000. That means I need 1000 cycles. I want to run my machine through 1000 cycle. You can clearly set from here. Right now I have, just as I have shown, I have set it 100. So next is number of cavities, guys. So what is the number of cavities? Number of cavity means how much product you are making in a single shot, in a single cycle. Like here it's two here. That means it's of two cavity, double cavity mold. And if you how much cavity is there, you can set here like 1 2 3 4 5 6. How you can set it, that I have shown you right now. So here you will get a clear idea. Remaining cycle counter means that how much your cycle has been left. For example, right now I have set in 100. That means total 100 remaining cycle counter. That means my machine is not running right now. So whatever I have set in the required production, similar is here in the remaining cycle counter, that is 100. If I would have used something like 10 cycle would have been run, then the remaining cycle would have been 100 minus 10, that is 90 cycle. So that is the thing that you have to remember in the mind, that what is remaining cycle counter. Remaining cycle counter means how much cycle is being left after your number of cycle that has been counted in the context of required production. So next is total cycle counter. Here you will get how much total cycle has been done. And total part counter means how much part you have count has been ejected out. For example, number of cavities 1. So if your machine will run 100 cycle, then total part will be 100 pieces. And if the number of cavity will be 2 and you have run completely 100 cycle, then it will be 200. You can clearly see that if I will set the number of cavities 2, two cavity mold is there, double cavity mold, then here the total part will be 200 pieces if it run the 100 cycle. If I would set here 3, then it would have been 300. So it's a clear thing that you can directly just multiply with your total cycle counter and you will get the exact answer for the number of pieces. Now next is total shot counter. That means how much total your shot run in the machine, the how much complete cycle run by your machine. Just like bike, we what happen in the bike, if you run 4000-5000 kilometer, it will show here. And if you will make a trip of when we just fuel and we fill up the fuel and we just take the trip, that means the required production. Now no alarm after counted means you will not get any alarm after the counting has been done. The required counting that you have given, just like here you have set it 100 cycle. If the 100 cycle would have been completed, then there would be no alarm. If there is no alarm after counted has not been selected. So if you want to select it, that means if you want to activate the alarm, then this type of dialog box will appear when you will touch here and just set, click the OK, and you will see here alarm after counted with the greenish color. That means now if you will reach the 100th cycle, the alarm will rise and you can understand that my production, the limit of my production has been done, my required production has been completed. So this is the simple thing that you can understand from here. So guys, it's simple and it's important alarm after counted. Now moving to the next, total cycle counter reset. If you want to reset the entire cycle counter, that means total cycle counter, you can clearly see that. If you want to reset it, just click over there and you can directly reset it. So it's a bit easy one. You can understand each and every single thing in an easy way. That's why I'm creating a simple topic, topical video. You can just press here and total cycle counter will be zero here. Whatever the value will be there, it will be gone through zero. So please subscribe the channel, guys, and download our application Plastotech. And on that particular application, you will get the courses of injection molding machine. Just enroll it and learn step by step with me each and every single thing. My main aim, my main motto is to teach you all in a good way, so that each and everything should be clear in your mind. So guys, thank you for watching the entire video. Thank you and have a great day.